Hi and welcome everybody. Welcome to a new episode of Fresh Jazzy Sound. Freshly released vinyl with a jazzy vibe. Great example, we start off with Adam Scrimshire with Listeners. I picked this album specific as for the first one, for the first album to show, because of the label. It's released on the label Albert Favorites. And the story behind it, that's what I love about it. Albert Favorites is a reference to the tapes Albert made beginning of the summer of all the tracks he liked that year, put it on tape, and that's what got into the car when they drove for summer holiday. And the label is started by Adam Scrimshire, who is the grandson of Albert and who started the label. The music itself is UK, London scene based UK jazz with a lot of collaborations with other artists. So on this one, the flute, for example, is by Chick Wickham, who also really recently released a new album. But all the music I will play will have this feeling of a summer day with favorites to play when you're moving in the car. This one is featuring, I had not heard of her before, but the voices by Anis Fai. I'm not really sure if I'm pronouncing it correctly. And the next album for sure is also has a great summer vibe. And you could already hear it a little bit in this one. The Incognito had such a big influence also on the funky soul music from the UK, and that's also very true also for this one. Although I think, thinking about it, I think Delata also made, I don't know if it's the same group, also made albums or music in the late 90s. It is released on Delata Music, so it's, I don't really know if it's a private press or but they release it on their own label. I love this kind of music. It's breezy, it's light, it's positive, great vibe. Next album is a crazy album. Next one is an EP from France. By accident I saw it. Luckily I saw it because later on it became very expensive. And it is by WL. And if you have the chance, look up his name on YouTube. He shows some short videos where he shows how he makes this music. It's brilliant because it's a one-man band. He loves the vocoder. He's a little bit crazy. But the music, okay? I don't know where the jazzy vibe is on this one. But this boogie sound, I love it. And just the way he has like 10, 20 synthesizers, and it all, he always makes his boogie sounds on it, little bit of vocals, and that bumping bounce, and the bass. I mean, it's a little bit, you have this also from American artists who, I would not say copy this sound, because he clearly copied the sound from the 80s, but his interpretation is so good. Little bit of Bruno Mars and Timberlake. but it has its own touch, really. This one, I rate it higher. Now we go to Africa, where in the 80s they also discovered the boogie sound. And this is a reissue of Dipson and Epsody called Justice. It's released on Dig This Way Records, and when I met the people behind the label in person, we got talking about Afro music, Afro funk, and they gave this to me. So big thank you to Joe Paco for giving this to me. And what is fun, it is originally released on Will Films. And Will Films is of course by label started by Willem Onjabor. And it comes originally from 1984. And I don't know if it has ever been officially released at that time or only in very low quantities. Now we got another reissue, and maybe I should first only play the music and not show the cover, because it's a little bit intriguing, the music itself, to recognize it. Though it's not that difficult. Well, actually it's very difficult. If somebody would have played it to me and say, who is playing? It's early 70s, it has a very strong James Brown sound. And I must say, it was Steve Carson who tipped me on this album. So thank you, Steve, for showing it. I hope you still have this album and it is not somewhere destroyed. But it's especially the bass and the guitar that you maybe recognize. And it's Bootsy Collins with his brother, Petfish. And I didn't know this, but it seems that when the JBs split up in the 70s, or Bootsy Collins and his brother left, they did not automatically start with George Clinton. They first had their own band, the House Guests. And I think it's only for 1 year or close to two, and then they got into the P-Funk with George Clinton. And this is a collection of the singles they released at that time. Very loose, very funky, and you can already see the transitions. The singles at the start really have that sharp and disciplined James Brown sound, and it gets looser and looser over time, there are these singles. And I must say, I like especially the first ones. Very surprising to know this kind of music, or that they make this kind of music at that time. I was really surprised. Oh, and on the back there is also a nice story of their history, which was very educational. The next album is a classic. It's for me also a reissue. Never seen an original. From the same time as the House Cats, so beginning of the 70s. If I'm right, by the way, or is it late 60s? It does not say. It's for the first time reissued in 1996. But this is the 2019 reissue on Love and Hate. They include a CD, the Pharaohs, and for some this is the start of Earth, Wind and Fire, because Morris White and other people were part of the band. It's very true, but Earth, Wind and Fire had a lot of changes before they really got their own sound. but that does not take away anything from this album because it's unique in its own sense. And in a way, it's not good that that split it to Earth with the Fire in another direction. It would have been great if this band stick together and made more albums. They did one album after this, and that's included on the CD and the download you get with this album. So this reissue from 2019 is very nice. That's a nice bonus. And the last album I want to show is by the Olympians. I missed this one when it was originally released, not that long ago. I believe it's 2016 or 2017. I will check the album cover. So it's the Olympians. Where is the date? 2016, yes, I was correct. So this is the band from the Deftones. It's their own label or their own album, completely instrumental. And what sets it apart from the Deftones singles, it's a little bit more laid back, and for an album that's perfect. It has not that high energy you expect with singles, a little bit lower, but because of that, it's a very nice album just to listen to have it playing in the background. But it's clearly Deftones, so it has that 70s soul funk vibe to it. But I was surprised by this one, and I don't know if I skipped it earlier, but when I found it, and you can still find it for very reasonable prices, it's actually dropped from the level it was released from. It's a nice one to pick up if you like this kind of music. But this is the end of the episode Fresh Jesse Finals. Hope you liked it. Thank you for watching. See you next time.